thank you for coming out this evening to commemorate a day that we will never forget, 9/11. I want to thank Prince George's Peace and Justice Coalition for sponsoring this event, and ask Donnie to come up and stand for the awards.
So we're very fortunate to have Renaud Grand and his pianist Vincent Henningfield with us tonight. Renaud graduated from Shenandoah University, and he works with the Charm City Labor Chorus. You might have seen the chorus on Labor Day. They were in the parade, and they were also at the New Deal afterwards. Vincent also works with the Charm City Labor Chorus, and let me see if I can remember the other things you told me. He works with various choruses in the Baltimore area and Delaware, Virginia. He works with Org Kids, which is the Baltimore Symphony Orchestra outreach for kids who don't have music education in school.
That's right.
An improvisation-based rock band.
Yes.
So these two will be singing music for those people who are no longer able to speak for themselves.
Is America any safer? Since 9/11, the United States has spent $1 trillion to defend against Al-Qaeda and ISIL, dirty bombs and lone wolves, bioterror and cyber terror. Has it worked? 15 years ago, this was taken from something written last year by the Atlantic. 19 terrorists using four jetliners as guided missiles killed 2,977 people and enveloped the country in fear. It was the first sustained attack on American soil since the bombing of Pearl Harbor, which was a far-off military base. This massacre hit the center of our government and blasted away part of our most iconic skyline. It left a stench that New Yorkers could smell weeks later as remains continued to be recovered from the ashes. Suddenly, we were vulnerable, not just to disease, tornadoes, accidents, or criminals, but to the kinds of enemies that had always threatened us, but never us. Others, but never us. Barack Obama remembers that after the second plane hit, he left the Chicago building that housed his state senate office. I stood in the street and looked up at the Sears Tower, fearing it might be a target too. He told me in a recent email exchange, adding, "I remember rocking Sasha to sleep that night, wondering what kind of world our daughters were going to grow up in." He continued, "With nearly 3,000 people killed in the places where we lived our daily lives, there was a feeling that our homeland was truly vulnerable for the first time. This is the story of the first 15 years of how we have dealt with that newfound fear. How we have confronted, sometimes heroically and sometimes irrationally, the mechanics, the politics, and the psychic challenges of the September 12 era. Have we succeeded in toughening up what overnight became known as Homeland Security? Absolutely, but not without a series of extravagant boondoggles along the way. Are we safer? Yes, we're safer from the kind of orchestrated attack that shocked us on that September morning.
Okay.
It's hard for terrorists to get into the country, and harder for them to pull off something spectacular if they do. But we have not plugged some of the most threatening security gaps. Worse, as the Orlando massacre reminded us, the world has become more populated by those who want to exploit those gaps, including those living among us, and who in the United States can easily obtain military-grade weapons. They're not deterred by the prospect of their own death, and they are happy to commit acts less ambitious than those of 9/11. That makes their attacks much harder to detect in advance. Our defenses are far stronger, but what we have to defend against has outpaced our progress. Have we adjusted politically and emotionally so that we can make rational decisions as a government and as a people to deal with the ongoing threat? Not yet. In a bitterly divided democracy where attention spans are short, civic engagement is low, and the potential for oversimplification and governing by headlines is high, that is hardly a surprise. But in those first hours after the planes hit their targets, we did answer the call, which required an almost complete turnaround of America's mindset and produced just as stunning a turnaround in our security posture.
Sent me as a seal upon.
at Morgan State, Dr. James Lee. He's still an adjunct professor of the faculty. Got my master's there in 2009.
Thank you. Thank you.
From a set of 24 other spiritual arrangements.
Thank you. horrified, keep thinking you can never win, cause you're not qualified. But then you sleep for many nights, thinking, oh, this is so wrong, we grew strong.
See?